So, psychologist, can you give any, I guess, aspiring language learner out there any tips on language learning?
You were born in East Germany, right?
Yes.
Were you a spy? Hallo, ich bin Raul. Ich bin Amerikaner. Das ist ein Interviewpartnerin. Sie ist aus Deutschland. Wir sind in Puerto Escondido, Mexiko.
Hi, ich bin Ygritte. Ich komme aus Deutschland, bin Psychologin und Coach und reise durch die Welt und liebe Sprachen.
Donc, je pense que cette personne est intéressante. Tu peux parler beaucoup de langues, non? Le français, le russe, portugais, anglais, allemand, c'est ta langue natale. Donc, pourquoi tu as décidé d'apprendre toutes ces langues? Pour le travail?
À l'école, j'ai appris le russe et l'anglais. Quand le mur est tombé en Allemagne de l'Est, je ne savais pas quoi faire et je suis sortie comme fille au père à Paris. Et à Paris, je suis rentrée dans un job dans les restaurants. Et comme ça, c'était plutôt pour se vivre. Il n'y avait pas une autre solution que apprendre les langues.
Cette pression, les températures, oh là là.
Oh là là, c'est parti, hein.
Agora a gente vai falar português do Brasil. Quando você começou a falar a língua portuguesa, você notou que a sua personalidade mudou? O alemão é uma língua muito forte. A maneira que vocês falam a língua é muito reservado. Eu não sei. Os brasileiros são muito abertos.
Alegre.
Sim, certo. A música,
sim.
As pessoas. Você notou que a sua personalidade muda com a língua?
Eu penso sim, porque brasileiro, o português do Brasil, está com muito mais melodia na dentro de conversação, na comunicação. Senti mais alegre quando eu falo português, por exemplo. Sempre uma aventura para mim de aprender mais.
So basically the reason I brought on Grit is because I think she's really wonderful. She's very smart and talented. It's not all the time you get to meet another polyglot. She's a psychologist. So I thought it'd be even more interesting to bring her on if you would be able to talk about like the psychology of language learning. Maybe can you talk a little bit about the fear of learning the language and like actually speaking to the people? Because I feel that's a big fear a lot of people have. They're scared of talking to people, like they're scared of the judgment.
First reason is why these people are afraid maybe to speak is because they learn the language at school and then you get a grade for what you are doing. They are not so intelligent or picking up it easily. They learn that language learning is a bad thing. As soon they go out, they cannot switch this experience. The experience outside while traveling, talking to people is so different because you don't get a grade. And I guess this is the first thing for the consciousness to understand that there's no school anymore, you can express yourself how you want, and if you make a mistake, the other person, maybe the native, will give you like a feedback and say, oh, we say it like this.
There's people that are, I guess, wanting to learn that next language, or what do you think are the advantages of being a polyglot? Besides the fact that you can communicate with a lot of people.
If you go to countries like Africa, where the infrastructure is not so good, if you don't know a certain word, you really struggle to go from place A to B. It's really a question to survive.
You were born in East Germany, right?
Yes.
Were you a spy?
No. I was 15 years old.
It's so good I should be a spy.
Yeah.
You speak so many languages, so...
Maybe I should be a spy. That's a good idea.
I think I'd be good. Growing up in East Germany, under the Soviet control, was Russian a mandatory language?
Yes, because everybody had to learn it, but we didn't speak that in the streets.
Mm-hmm.
So that was our first language at schools.
So you're a psychologist. Can you give any, I guess, aspiring language learner out there any tips on language learning? Like that helped you, I guess, learn so many languages?
Yeah, so the first thing, I guess, is don't be afraid of mistakes. If I say a wrong word and another person is laughing about it and making jokes, don't get irritated. You say, yeah, that was funny, you know, I did a mistake, that's life. And just be confident. It's maybe the second advice I give, to be confident that you are in a process. You go from one step to another step, and it's not a fast thing to learn. So be patient and also make breaks of learning. like have enough sleep, do some sports. It's always better for the brain than always like to focus too much. It's not good.
Do you want to talk about a little bit about what you do now, like your books?
The main point is that we have such a high amount of information and it can distract our brain. So we are not efficient most of the time. I'm describing some rules and some tips in my book how you can reduce the consumerism of information and what to do instead.
I'll put the link of the book down below in the description. If you like this video, guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, share with your guys' friends or more videos like this. How do you say goodbye in Russian?
Dos vidanya.
Dos vidanya.